Let's take this opportunity to head out to Marshall Space Flight Center in Huntsville, Alabama, where Lori Meggs is standing by. Lori, you're going to talk to us about a great educational tool there that helps both students and the space station program.
That is right, Nicole. Flight controllers here in the Payload Operations Integration Center go through months, even years of training and certification. And all of that begins right here where I'm standing. In the room behind me is called the Lab Training Complex, and it is a mock-up of the U.S. laboratory. But that's not the most interesting thing about it. The most interesting thing is that it was mostly built by high school students. It's part of a program called High School Students United with NASA to Create Hardware, or HUNCH. And joining me now is Bob Zeek. You are the co-founder of HUNCH. And tell us how all this got started and what it's all about, Bob.
Well, you know, HUNCH, the acronym, High School Students United with NASA to Create Hardware, was started back in 2003. So we're in our 10th year anniversary this year. So it started on the basis of we didn't have any training hardware to train our astronaut crew in Houston or our flight controllers upstairs. So we came up with the notion of going to the high schools and getting them to build training hardware that we use every day in our operations.
A unique thing. Let's look at some of the hardware here.
Well, what we've got, we have quite a few different curriculums we support. We have a computer electronics. Basically, these are utility outlet panels, power bricks. This is a test model here we use to do a lot of different checkouts for software control and things of that nature. We have rapid prototyping through a CAD drafting class, 3D rapid prototype print, machine shop. We have lots of machine parts here that the kids do CNC machining on.
I bet they get excited about this, too. Tell us, how many schools are involved in this?
We have 53 schools across the nation, 18 different states we represent. Our areas include Alabama, Tennessee, Mississippi, Louisiana, Texas, the Midwest, a few on the East Coast, and just sprinkled, you know, throughout the continent. So.
And I mentioned you're the co-founder. You and someone at Johnson Space Center actually came up with this idea.
In 2003, myself and a guy named Stacy Hale out of Houston, he's basically the guy that controls the money, and he's made it happen, and we have to give him a big round of applause for supporting us in that venue. So.
Touched a lot of students. What else do we have here?
I talked about sewing is our biggest one. The schools in Houston do a lot of sewing.
We I don't do any sewing, so that's impressive to me.
Cargo transfer bags are quite valuable in space, and we have 200 of those flying now that this high school built for European Space Agency, and they're flying them in their space projects.
So it's not just training. This is actual flight hardware.
Flight hardware there, that is correct. And then we have welding. Welding supports a lot of our framework you see behind us. It's amazing what the students could do to get that erected for us and delivered and set up and pretty much to scale.
Now, how is this used, this room behind us? How is it used once you have all that hardware in there?
We have flight controllers upstairs. We give them that third dimension of coming out and touching, feeling, pushing the hardware, pushing connectors and disconnecting switches and things of that nature. And it just gives them a hands-on opportunity to see what they're really working with in space.
And someone who's really had his hands on this is Mike Evans. And Mike, come on in here. You are a drafting teacher at the Huntsville Center for Technology. And your students, you're actually holding something that they built for this place.
Absolutely. We were one of the original schools that started with Bob in 2003. And what this program allows the students to do, it allows us to get them out of the textbook and work on the STEM activities and, you know, the engineering skill sets that they need to be successful later in life. So that's one of the great things about this program. You know, it's a resume, it's a portfolio builder for these students.
What do the students say when you come in and say, okay, we're building something for the space station program?
Well, it's unbelievable to those guys. You know, it's exciting. It generates a lot of interest. And it's almost a carrot on the end of the string, too, because, you know, in my program, it pretty much applies to the more advanced students, the second-year students. So it gives, coming in as a junior, as a beginning student, it gives them something to work toward and look forward to.
Tell us about this part you're holding here.
Well, this is an example of a STEM project. It's just an assembly part that's used for the rack drawer system and some of the payloads back here. And what it requires is a lot of engineering skill sets. It allows them to work with Bob and other engineers on designing and 3D modeling these things. And most of all these parts that you see on the table were some that we originally designed for Bob. So anything that we can create three-dimensionally, we can create a rapid prototype through our 3D rapid prototyping machine there at school. So what that allows the students to do, it actually allows the students to work with something from start to finish, you know. And the great thing about that is it allows them to see their mistakes and learn and build from those mistakes.
Starting a new school year next week, any big plans for the space station program this time?
Well, just whatever comes across the table. We're always excited to get that work in for the students. And again, it gets them out of the textbook, and that's something that in a normal high school setting they just do not get to experience.
All right, Mike, thank you very much. And Bob, I know you're proud because actually the guy standing back there working here, right, he started in Hunch,
yeah,
right?
He's a Hunch graduate. He's been with us for 7 years now, working on his college degree. He's just one semester away, so he's going to be a fresh hire in for us.
And I know that makes you proud. And lastly, how can schools get involved and be a part of the Hunch program?
We have a website, nasahunch.com. We also have flyers at local schools. The interest is available to all the different schools that want to apply. There is an application form online, and we review those once a year, and then if you're a candidate, we'll come to your school, visit, make sure we got the right stuff in place, and try to get you on board.
I'm going to go practice on my sewing skills or something like that, Bob, help you guys out. Thank you so much. A great program, the Hunch program. And let's take a live look inside the Payload Operations Integration Center. Working today, Jay Nichols is the pod, and he's being assisted by TJ Creamer, the dual TJ Creamer. He's an astronaut and a payload operations director. And actually, Jay is actually in the middle of that training. And if you see some of the folks in there wearing the nice Hawaiian shirts, they're celebrating Japanese Aloha Day today in the middle of all the work they're doing.